this year, 2016, has been a year for the books for sure. I mean, my buddy Jake here has been running trail camps since August and putting in food plots and, you know, putting out feed and just really been trying to track down the deer that we want to hunt, you know, get them separated from the ones we're going to let walk, because we have some awesome properties. And, you know, they didn't let us down this year. Just, it was tough. We had a lot of warm weather early on. Early season was pretty tough. I don't think we had much opportunities at deer early season. And then rut rolled around and we had a lot of good action. You know, I pulled out every string in the book, or pulled every string I had, you know, every play in the book, and I tried rattling and, you know, grunting, and I was on deer, you know, really nice 150, 160 inch deer, and I just couldn't quite close the deal. They I had several opportunities. I drew back on one real nice 11 point. You'll see in the footage here, I drew back on him twice, and he was at 30 yards, and I just couldn't get a clear shot. The next morning, I went out and had another encounter with a great deer and had him at 80 yards, and I couldn't get him coaxed in, and that's just kind of the way this season went.
Time to ditch that old salt block and corn pile routine. Our two-part mineral and protein attractant system means more inches in your trophy room. Don't let the next big thing pass you by. Time for change. It's Deer 30.
Calhoun Outfitters, located just west of Delta, Colorado, providing fully and semi-guided elk, mule deer, and black bear hunts in the beautiful backcountry of the Colorado Mountain Plateaus. Great family atmosphere and knowledgeable guide to put you on that trophy of a lifetime. Give Scott Calhoun a call or check him out on Facebook.
When you take to the turkey woods, what do you have in your vest?
It's tough to get time out to hunt, especially for two people. You know, we both work 50-hour plus a week, but we make time to get out there in the woods and try to hunt together. We've been hunting together a long time, a lot of years, so. I don't know how many doctor's appointments you had in the mornings to come film for me.
Yeah.
Hopefully your bosses don't watch this episode, but a lot of deer walk we both did. I think we both probably let more deer walk than most hunters would, but when you're going after mature deer, you gotta let the young ones go, and a lot of the properties we hunt, we feel like we can let the younger ones walk and they're going to live, and we'll see them again next year and probably get sheds off of them and keep managing them, you know.
Yeah, several years you've had some big deer on camera. I mean, heck, your dad took that one. What year was it?
Yeah, actually this 2013, my dad took a real nice 27-point, 212-inch buck off the property that I hunt quite regularly, and we have sheds for him, and we chased him for 7 years. I mean, you can let them deer go, and you'd be amazed at what they turn into.
Yeah, you put all the time to get in the deer, and then your dad get it all because he had to go to work that day.
Out of state working, and let him hunt my stand. I actually coaxed him into hunting. They say they want to hunt that day. It's too windy, but Caleb had actually shot a real nice buck that day, and I seen several other people had filled their tags, and I said, you gotta get out there, it's November in Kansas, you need to get out there, them big deer are on the move. And there's a lot of deer that have a lot of, you know, unique racks, a lot of kickers, and you know, not so much just mainframe straight 10 points or 8 points. There's a lot of good genetics in that area. That's just like that other property up north that we've been kind of hunting the last 2 years. We have some monster deer on camera there. It's about a 45-minute drive from home, so getting time to drive up there and check cameras and, you know, put out clock stopper and put food plots in. We spend a lot of time, a lot of miles driving, but it's worth it when you see them big deer on camera. Even better when you get to see them. Jacob Beamer, Archery Assassins Pro Staff here, and my good buddy Jacob Gravatt. We just shot a pretty nice buck. I thought we got some footage of it. The sun is kind of not our friend right now. It's only about 4:30 in the afternoon, but pretty cold today. I think a high, 12 degrees today?
Yeah, maybe 8 now.
Yeah, might be 8 degrees now. This morning, it's a real feel, negative 20. We got about 3 inches of snow last night, but I come in and checked the camera today and had a pretty decent buck coming in regularly. You know, it's late season. We decided to get in here and give it a whirl. Heck, we just got in the blind. We didn't want to get in too early and get frizzed out before it was really good hunting time. But we got in the blind and just getting set up. And I was trying to hide out of the sun. I was over in the corner of the blind. Jake said, there's a buck right there.
I didn't have an arrow even knocked yet. I'm still getting everything situated.
I think he was bedded just a little bit from the corn pile because he could see some steam come out of his breath and seen him stand up and shake his rack off and whatnot. And it was kind of tough. I went ahead and hit record on the camera, and I couldn't even see him until he ended up walking past us once. And he drew on him, couldn't quite get a clear shot, had a little bit of a cedar tree in his way, it looked like.
Some sticks or something. And
he luckily come back and give us another shot.
looked like he put a pretty good shot on him, so we're going to wait a few minutes here and go out and see if we can recover the arrow and try to find, pick up some blood. Should be pretty easy finding the snow we have. It's pretty hard snow. It's pretty not real flaky, so blood should stay on top of it, but I don't think we're in the blind 15 minutes, maybe.
Maybe. Yeah, even that quick. Long. Didn't just long get cold, at least.
Yeah, that's right. That's the way to do it. You know where the deer, you know, if the deer are coming in, it's pretty cold. They're usually up on their feet this time of year, so stay tuned. We'll go out and try to find some blood.
Didn't get nothing during rut, so led the late season, and here we are stuck hunting when it's cold, and should be home watching TV or football or something. Nope, we're out there still chasing deer.
Out there toughing it out, but that's what makes it fun, makes it interesting. That's what led us to his deer this year. I hadn't filled my tag yet, but I still had a couple bruisers on camera that I really wanted to concentrate on, so I asked him if he wanted to try to fill his tag on this buck that had been coming in quite regularly, and we were lucky enough. The cold weather we had that week, it really had the deer up moving, and he was able to put a nice, a perfect shot on a nice buck.
Calhoun Outfitters, located just west of Delta, Colorado, providing fully and semi-guided elk, mule deer, and black bear hunts in the beautiful backcountry of the Colorado Mountain Plateaus. Great family atmosphere and knowledgeable guide to put you on that trophy of a lifetime. Give Scott Calhoun a call or check him out on Facebook.
When you take to the turkey woods, what do you have in your vest? Time to ditch that old salt block and corn pile routine. Our two-part mineral and protein attractant system means more inches in your trophy room. Don't let the next big thing pass you by. Time for change. It's Deer 30.
Jacob Beamer with Archery Assassins Pro Staff. My good buddy Jacob Gravatt here. We just got done shooting this nice deer here in Kansas. What is it today? December
18th?
Yeah, like the 18th or 19th. Probably 18th, I guess. A week from Christmas. Kind of late season, but we've both been struggling this year and kind of holding out on some bigger deer. And we decided to come out this evening and actually had some trail cam pictures of this buck. he's been pretty regular, and I knew with this cold weather we have, this is kind of the first cold front we really had this year, but it got cold last night, like negative 20 this morning wind chill.
Negative 8 actual temperature.
Yeah, negative 8 actual temperature, so pretty cold, but we had a good idea this deer would be on his feet, but he came in a little earlier than we thought. He actually come in, about probably 4:15 when Jake seen him. I was just getting set up. I was kind of hiding over in the corner of the blind, staying out of the sun. And he told me, hey, there's a buck coming in. Sure enough, it was one we were after. So he kind of come by the blind and didn't offer much of a shot. And they come back in, and Jake put a pretty good shot on him. We trailed him, probably about 150, 200 yards here. But pretty easy trailing him in the snow. We were able to follow his tracks most of the time, just making sure we're on blood. Pretty neat deer. He's got a nice little split on his brow here. Pretty heavy. Kind of narrow, but you know, it gets late season. There's only a week and a half of season left. Kind of take them as you can get them. Jake was nice enough to let me video him tonight. We've kind of been videoing for each other on and off the last couple of years, so luckily we were able to get it done. Probably might have an inside point there, broken off too.
Yeah, we've been hunting together, duck hunting, deer hunting, about anything that moves. Been hunting together for probably close to 20 years now.
Yeah, it's been quite a while. So we high school together, small town life, and hunting, fishing, stuff like that, outdoor life.
Yeah, our parents have been good friends. They actually, went a couple of years without seeing each other and ran into each other again and found out they both had a son. They both named us Jacob. It was kind of ironic. Started going to school. You started going here in what, third grade?
Yeah, third grade when I moved here and started going to school here.
Same class, and been hunting and fishing together ever since.
Yeah, it's, I think we met at the Old Blue, actually. Yeah. our parents met up and
ran into each other fishing. Our parents were fishing. We were probably playing with sticks, who knows.
But it went on from there, that's for sure. And kind of, he got me into bow hunting. We got to start duck hunting, stuff like that, waterfowl. And then he's always been into bow hunting. I kind of wasn't too interested in it at first until I got out there and realized how much fun it is, how much it really takes to get into bow hunting.
Yeah, it takes a lot more time and patience. You know, it's fun to go out and shoot some ducks, but it's a little different setting a tree stand for 3 months chasing one deer or two deer, you know, that you have on camera, and trying to wait for that mature buck to come in. And that's kind of what led us into this hunt. You know, it's late season here in Kansas, and we both have been filming for each other on and off all year, but each had a couple deer that we had our eyes set on, and it didn't happen during rut. You know, we had a lot of opportunities, and they just didn't quite go the way we planned. A little mishaps with trying to run the camera and film each other, or even solo filming every now and then, but we finally got some nice cold weather, and I went out and checked this trail cam this morning and put out some more deer 30 clock stopper, and had a nice buck that really been coming into the feed pretty regularly, and decided to ask Jake if he was interested in trying to take it.
Well, my luck's been going. I was going to jump on every opportunity I could to get on a good deer, so I took him up on the deal.
Yep.
And we went out there and kind of didn't want to get there too early because it was pretty cold out.
Had a little snow on the ground. And got into the blind, the sun was just beating in the blind. You know, we were looking off to the west, and that sun was just starting to set, coming in through the window of the blind. Made it pretty difficult to see, but he actually seen this nice deer stand up from his bed and come in. We didn't get a whole lot of footage of him coming in. I couldn't even see him looking into that sun, but he came by and actually passed by the blind at first. He was acting a little nervous, but we thought it was over. Thought we might have made a mistake not getting a shot off that first time he come by, but he turned back around and come back in again.
guess he couldn't resist that food or something. He walked right past, was staring us down like he'd seen us, but then he turned around and came right back, and it was pretty, played out pretty well. So
kind of a quick hunt, but I'm not complaining as cold as it was.
Jacob Beamer with Archery Assassins Pro Staff here today. It is October 20th from Kansas. We finally kind of got a cold front. Highs today were in the 60s, maybe low 60s. A little bit of rain. We've had record heat the last couple of days, so decided to jump out and get in a stand. The stand I'm hunting this evening, pretty simple. Got a hedgerow running straight north of me here, and then another one that runs back to the east. I like this stand because I can see a mile in every direction. It's a good observation stand. Kind of see what's going on out here.